Hello everyone and welcome back to Ranch Street. When I tell y'all it's always something, it is always something. My tripod broke. I'm gonna order a new one, but I hope this doesn't slow me down with like getting videos recorded. Besides all that, hello everyone, it's time for another album of the week. Album of the week. Yep. Anyway, today's album is one of my favorites. I feel like I say that a lot, but y'all, I cannot say that I have like a favorite artist, a favorite song, a favorite, like I just can't pick just one. So when I say that, just accept it. So this is one of my favorite albums. It came out 2 years ago, I'm pretty sure, and it is PJ Morton Gumbo live recording. Y'all, PJ Morton, I love him, I love his father, I love the Lord. So I'm gonna, of course, talk about what he wanted us to get from the album, and then I'll go into the three songs in honorable mention, and we're gonna get through this, you guys, because this album is everything. It's a lot of, it's not what you would expect to be mainstream. He was nominated for 2 Grammys from this album. One was for Best R&B Album, and one was Best R&B Song for First Began. And to be honest, I can see why it was nominated. It was very creative in a sense of, I'm gonna do this live session album, I'm gonna take it serious, we're gonna sing these songs, we're gonna play these instruments, and you guys are gonna hear what I have to say. And I heard you, PJ, I love you. Okay, so Gumbo is a story of struggle, resistance, and hope. PJ Morton channeled musicians from the civil rights era, and his upbringing in church makes him hopeful for the country's future despite the division that has emerged. Now, I wanted to talk about the whole album, but I was like, you know, I'm not gonna do that because I keep doing it and it's a lot of stuff to cut and everything, add the songs, you know. So I'm gonna stick with the 3 songs in an honorable mention, but I will highly say that you should listen to the album in its entirety. It is very much it has some gems in there that make you think, especially with chasing your dreams, being in love, overcoming things. This album very much showed me a mature adult wrote this, and they want you to learn some things. So sorry for my tatas, I can't help it. So the first song that I just spoke to me was First Began. When I tell you guys, this song is so beautiful. This song is beautiful. It made me want to fall in love. Why am I tearing up? It makes my heart yearn for something. Mind you, I'm 22. I have a lot of life ahead of me. There's no rush for me to get married, to have kids. But you know how sometimes you just feel, you feel like, I would love to fall in love. This song made me want to fall in love and be the way we were when we first began. You know, every love story is not rainbows and butterflies. Like, it's not. But there is a sense of desire when it comes to love. And this song right here, y'all, PJ's voice, I watched him do another live session of this album, and when he sung this song in particular, he sung it to his wife, And it was just like, oh, I don't have relationship goals. Never have. I don't believe in this celebrity fan type thing. I don't have a favorite celebrity. I don't have a favorite anything really. I love everyone. Everyone has creativity and gifts and stuff. But when it comes to love, music is what I go to. I don't go to people, if that makes sense. And this song right here, when he was singing this to his wife, I was just like, that's gonna be me one day. I'm gonna be singing to my husband, or he gonna be singing to me, and it's just gonna be love. When I tell y'all, I could just talk about it all day. I'm gonna play a little bit of it right here.
You've got something special, hold on, don't let go. And I'll never find another. You and this I know. If I did, I'd hope to find you in another life, so we could fall.
The lyrics, the piano, the tone. He means that thing. When I tell you PJ meant that thing, he meant that thing. And I'm so happy he wrote this song. First Began. That was track number one, y'all. Hopefully you guys listen to it and you love it just as much as me. We could talk about it, you know. We could talk about it. Okay. Song number two is Go Through Your Phone. Now, I love the camaraderie that he had with the audience in this song. I think that's why I really like it, because people was giving their amens, people was giving their yeses and their claps and all that stuff, and it very much made me smile. One. Two, I don't have my glasses, y'all. When I tell you piano live jam sessions, I want to do it one day. I don't know how to play the piano yet, but I want to do it one day. But this was everything to me. By now you know I like his voice. His voice is creative. It very much reminds me of my church upbringing. If you did not know, I was brought up very heavily in the church. I still believe in God to this day. You are my rock, Jesus. And this very much made me think of his tone. The raps made me think of church. And when I tell you, this man is a genius. You know how, like, you'll hear something, and then if you avidly listen to music or play instruments or nothing, something, sing even, you know that face. You know that face you make when somebody just did that. I don't wanna go through your phone. I was doing this. The piano and whatever instrument, I think it was the guitar, the guitar in the back. Simple. It was simple placements of those instruments, and it was so good. Like, he didn't do too much, have too much production, didn't have, like, they were just playing instruments and he was singing, had his background vocals, and it was masterful. I was like, oh my God, he did that. Because, you know, a lot of songs today, and I'm not throwing shade, because, you know, times change, music changes, everything. But when he decided to do a piano live jam session, or a live jam session, I don't know why I keep putting piano in there, but when he decided to do that, he knew that people are going to be listening to me sing, but at the same time, I want that music to hit, and it did. I'm going to play a clip of it right here.
See, we're here in love, yeah. It's what I say. And nobody's perfect. I don't want to see something to change my mind. Everything is cool, and I think we're just fine. See, what I'm trying to say.
When I tell you specific placements, the beauty of music, I was just like, oh my God, this is his gift. And I didn't know he played music with Maroon 5. And Maroon 5 is one of my favorite groups. And when I tell you, they do specific stuff in the back of their music. And I'm kind of like, I'm falling in love with artists that do specific detailing in their music. Because I love listening to the background and hearing what she's like in the last video with Queen Herbie, where I was like, it sound like in that song Wild, it sound like a cowbell. Like, that was really drew my ear to the song, and I was like, I love this song, I love this album. Just masterful, intricate design of a song, and it was live. That is so crazy to me. I love it. That was number two. Number three. All right. Now, anyway, three, all right. You know, the lyrics really got to me in this song. Like, when it rains, it pours. But I know in my souls of souls, I know that it's gonna be all right. Like, I just know. I don't worry about things. I don't really have a lot of things on my mind. I don't know if it's because I have the Lord, but I just don't have time to be worrying about things. And this song right here spoke to me in that sense. The piano, the guitar, the drums, the little placements, little here and there. I could hear instruments. I'm not gonna say them specifically because I don't know. I didn't watch it live when he posted it, so I don't know what instruments are being played, but he did that thing, like, for real. This song is beautiful. I think the whole album is just beautiful. I hope you guys go listen. It is so good. Now,
we've been here before. You can check the score. Be alright, yeah. Be alright. Be alright. Oh, you know the numbers don't lie. Be alright. Be alright. Be alright. Alright.
Tone that he uses when he sings brings out his feelings to my very core. I felt like him singing this song to me, I was gonna be all right. Like, him singing it to me in my ears and my headphones, I was like, it's gonna be all right. Like, he said it, yeah, he mean it. It's gonna be all right. And then, you know, when it rains, sometimes it does pour. But I want to say to the viewers right now, whatever you're going through, especially in this time, in this pandemic, when so much is going on, we've seen so much happen with the pandemic itself, but then racism has become another issue, white supremacy has become another issue, your freedoms have become an issue, even sex trafficking is at an all-time high. It's like, oh my gosh. But the God I believe in, the God I know, I can't sit in the negative. I just cannot, and think that everything is going to end in disaster. It's just not how I'm built. I know it's gonna be okay. And I want whoever's watching this to know that you are gonna be okay. Everything. It's gonna be okay. I hope that you're having a great day, and I love you, but it's gonna be all right. Chin up, smile. Maybe it'll make you feel better. And that brings me to the honorable mention, which is the last song on this album, Everything's Gonna Be All Right. When I tell you, my favorite part of this song is gonna be, everything's gonna be all right. Gonna be, everything's gonna be alright. It will be alright, alright. It's gonna be alright. When I tell y'all, I don't know why it made me think of church, of course, but it also made me like really appreciate instruments, because do y'all hear the musicians going ham in the back of this song? I'm gonna play it right here. The background vocals held it down. Okay, the breakdown was amazing. I put 1s, 2s, and 3s on this because when I tell you, the breakdown was amazing. Loved the guitar. The lyrics, we already talked about All Right. This was a continuation of All Right, Everything Gonna Be All Right. They did that. The harmonies. The harmonies. I love harmonies. I don't know why. The audience helping him sing this song was like the final nail in the house. Like it built a masterful mansion, because I don't know, the audience singing it with him kind of affirmed what the song was saying. We're gonna jam out, we gonna have fun with it, we gonna do all of this. Everything's gonna be all right, and I just loved it. I love PJ Morton, I love this album, and I ain't mad at it. I want everyone to hear it, especially there's a song on there called Claustrophobic where he talks about how he was trying to get into the music industry here, a label in LA. And then he ended up moving back to his hometown and stuff because they wanted to change who he was. When I tell y'all, this album is good. I just highly recommend that you listen to Gumbo. It's a lot of stuff in there that are just gems. And I feel like a lot of people would enjoy it. So before I ramble on and on and on and on, I would say listen to Gumbo by PJ Morton. It is so good. I hope you enjoy it. I hope we can talk about it if you do listen to it, because I would love to. I hope you'd enjoy this video. I love talking about music. I can ramble. This video is so long because I can just ramble about it all day. But thank you so much for watching this video and sticking to the end. I hope that you have a blessed day. I hope that God continues to pour blessings upon blessings upon blessings in your life, because he will do just that. And I love you guys so, so, so much. Peace out.